Hey guys, JT Shaver here with New Layer, and if you've been wondering whether or not it's worth it to get a cage for your camera, this video is for you. There's about a million accessories you can get to make using your camera easier or add some functionality, but a lot of times they could actually get in the way because they're too big or too cumbersome and can actually slow you down when you're trying to get some work done. That's one of the main reasons why I rarely use gimbals, because as sad as it sounds, once I get everything set up and balanced, I start to lose motivation for what I wanted to film in the first place. Now, I'm definitely not an expert when it comes to using cages, but I wanted to share some of the things that I liked about mine because it really has helped me create more professional looking content. One of the first and most obvious advantages of using a cage is that it adds a ton of mounting points for all kinds of accessories. We're talking handles, lights, monitors, wireless transmitters, microphones, anything you can think of, or at least anything that has a 1/4 inch or 3/8 inch thread on it. Ironically, I usually don't attach much to my cage like most people, and I usually just have a couple side handles and a top handle. That brings me to my favorite reason to have a cage and what I think is the most important, and that is the added stability. The more stuff you add to your cage, the heavier it gets, and the heavier it gets, the more stable your footage becomes. That's one of the main reasons why handheld footage taken with a big cinema camera looks better than something taken with a really small point and shoot, because you just get way less of those micro jitters. On top of the extra weight, adding handles has some other big benefits. Number one is that you get more accurate camera movements. For the product B-roll in a lot of my reviews, I do a fair amount of orbiting shots where I stand above a product and move side to side while keeping the camera pointed at the product. When you're moving the camera around but trying to keep it pointed at something specific, it's much easier when you're holding something wider. So imagine you're holding a really small camera and trying to accurately move it side to side to keep it pointed at something specific, and then imagine holding something twice as wide and trying to do the same thing. In the first scenario, you only have to move each hand about a millimeter to turn the camera a few degrees, and in the second scenario, you have to move your hands about an inch to turn the camera that same few degrees. So adding handles to your cage makes a significant difference in how accurate your camera movements can be. Adding handles to your cage also adds even more mounting points, so you can really stack a ton of stuff onto a relatively small setup. If you look at more professional cage setups, you'll notice that the actual camera body makes up one of the smallest parts of the overall setup. Now, I don't have a particularly impressive cage setup, so to demonstrate this point, I asked Mac Olink to send me some footage of his setup. He's using a Z Cam, which is a little larger than a Sony a7R III like I have, and you can see that the accessories make up the bulk of his setup. He's also got a relatively new YouTube channel with some really great content, so after this, make sure you go show him some love. I don't know about other brands, but all the handles on my SmallRig cage have little Allen wrenches that are connected magnetically, so they're really easy to pop out and use to tighten the cage itself, or add other accessories, or use on tripod plates and things like that. One of the things that I find odd is that the 1/4-20 screw that comes with this cage to attach the actual camera does not have an Allen head socket in it. It's not a big deal to replace that, but it's something really obvious that they should have included to make adding the camera to this cage a lot easier and more secure. Another thing that a cage with handles gives me is the opportunity to get shots that would otherwise be really hard to get or even impossible. Most obviously would be shots that are low to the ground, because a top handle lets you more easily get down low, and if you have it balanced well, you can easily do some really cool faux crane shots where you lift the camera from low to high and get a really cool perspective. And if you have a monitor attached to your cage, you can turn it up or down, so it makes it a lot easier to monitor what you're doing if you're filming down low or above your head. The last thing that I want to mention about the handles is how easily customizable they are. So the top handle uses a NATO rail mount, so you can easily pop it off and switch it around to face the other direction if you need to get a different shot. The side handles that I have are the universal version, so they're not as easily customizable, but I decided to save some money there. But you can get versions that use NATO mounts, so you can more easily pop them off and back on whenever you need or don't need them. Now, I don't know anyone who buys a cage specifically for this next reason, but it also does protect your camera body against damage. If you drop your whole rig, you're probably going to damage something internally, but at least you won't have to pay for any body repairs. More importantly, you don't have to be as careful when you're picking it up or setting it down on surfaces that might damage the body of the camera, like rocks or dirt or sand or something like that. One other thing that I thought was worth mentioning is that having a handle on your cage makes carrying it around much easier when you're not actually using it. Especially with some cameras like a Z Cam that's just shaped like a little cube, there's really no easy way to grip it, so having a cage with a handle just makes it much easier. So when it comes to the type of work that I do, by the time I get a camera set up on a gimbal or a motorized slider, I can usually just pop it into my cage and finish getting the shots that I need before the setup with the other devices is even done. Obviously, it's not going to be quite as smooth as a slider or a gimbal, but it does make it smooth enough to where you can add some stabilization in post and basically get something that no one would ever know the difference. If you're doing some big budget projects, I would still highly recommend using a gimbal when you need super smooth shots, but in my opinion, a cage is one of the most versatile accessories because something like a slider kind of limits you on the types of shots you can get. That's kind of one of the overarching themes about this video and using a cage in general is that it'll make all of your footage look more professional, but you don't really have to have any special training or change anything from your regular workflow. It's one of the few things that you can buy that will legitimately make all of your footage look better without you having to work any differently. The biggest downside to having a cage, in my opinion, is that it will be really tempting to get all kinds of accessories to stick on top. So the cage that I have is for the Sony a7 III or a7R III, and it cost me $150. It came with the cage, the top handle, and a little articulating arm to add your first accessory. The side handles were $55 each, so this whole setup was about $250. There are some cheaper or more expensive brands of cages out there, but I really like the build quality and the design of my SmallRig cage so far. What about you? Do you think a cage is worth the price for what it does, or would you rather pick up a different accessory? Leave a comment and let me know what you think. I'll have links in the description for my setup, but SmallRig makes something for basically any setup you can think of. If this video helped you decide whether or not a cage might be good for you, make sure you hit subscribe because I do gear reviews like this every week. That's it for now, guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.